The following is a live presentation of Retro Sports Network, home of the champions of the past, present, and or future. I'm getting a finger wag from the wife. Say hi. Okay, barely in there. How are you? Good afternoon, good morning, good evening. My name is Ron Juckett. Welcome to the program for this 23rd day of February, 23. So it's 23-2-2-3-2-3. It's almost a Lawrence Welk number, isn't it? Anyway, so we're going to have the Seattle Mariners who get a couple streams this week. They have the White Sox today, and the White Sox are kind of settling in to win the wild card. Right now, it's a two-team race between Chicago and Boston for the wild card. Cleveland has overtaken the White Sox to go into first place in the American League Central, but it really should be a three-team battle royale for a while until injuries kind of take out the Red Sox. The Mariners, however, are in cruise control. This is their 39th game. They are 26-12. The A's really have not shown up yet. Hard to see how Oakland wins 100 games in this replay, considering that's what they did in real life, but yet, you just never know. And so the Mariners, a big lead in the American League West. They could almost start to print those playoff tickets. The White Sox, 24-12. They go with Biddle in a bullpen game. Paul Abbott gets a call for Seattle. Cool night here in Seattle. The games of Wednesday, May 16th, 2001. Next. As Retro Sports Network presents 2001, an Action PC Season Odyssey. Tonight, from Safeco Field in Seattle, Washington, it is the Seattle Mariners and the Chicago White Sox. And today's game is brought to you by DigitalDice.com, the best darn podcast on the web for your sports simulation and replay needs. Find us today on Spotify, Spreaker, iTunes, or wherever else fine podcasts are listed. You know, don't ask me again on the carrot browsing. It's something that I've had to choose every time. Anyway, Paul Abbott gets the call for Seattle, making his fourth start of the year. He is a better pitcher than his replay record so far, 1-1, with an earned run average of .594. Paul is 33, fastball tops out at 92. And the fly ball plus pitcher. His last start was May 11th against Toronto in a 10-9 win. Didn't take the decision. Five innings, 103 pitches, eight hits allowed. He was Christmas treed, six runs all earned. Two homers, he walked two and struck out four. By the way, at the end of April, he beat the White Sox at Comiskey over six innings almost. So Abbott, 16 2/3, 18 hits, 11 runs all earned. He's given up three homers. He's walked 10 and while striking out 16. The lineup for Chicago, Ray Durham leads off at second base. Jose Valentin is at short. He'll bat second. Lee is in left field. He'll bat third. Maggie Ordonez cleans up in right field. Paul Konerko is the DH today. He'll bat fifth. Leifer at first will bat sixth. Herbert Parry at third will bat seventh. Chris Singleton in center bats eighth. And Sandy Alomar Jr. behind the plate will go ninth. Biddle should throw about 90 pitches. Defensively for Seattle, Stan Javier is a 6-2 in left. Mike Cameron a 10-5 in center. He's your Woolworth player of the game. Ichiro is a 10-8 in right. Mark McLemore, a 5 at third. Carlos Guillen, a 3 at second. Brett Boone is a 6 at second. Guillen, a 3 at short. John Olerud, a 6 at first. It's Lampkin behind the plate. He's a 5-3. And Abbott is a 7 on the mound with a 1,000 fielding percentage. Durham steps in at 287, 8 homers and 21 RBI. 60 degrees, the roof is closed, calm winds. Just a cool night. Good night for the garlic fries and the grasshoppers here at Safeco Field. Durham laces it into left field to start the ball game. Javier will let it drop in front of him to hold Durham to a single. So that brings up Valentin Jose at 283, 9 homers and 29 RBI. Abbott throws to first. Durham is back. Valentin can bunt. Pitch out going to throw down again. Durham was going and he's gone. He gone. So they do the right thing and they pitch out. And Lampkin fired a strike down again, one out. And a one ball strike. It was a good game last night, Bernie. Glad you watched it. We got about 6 inches of snow so far out of the deal. Probably going to get 2 or 3 between now and Friday night to go on top of it. And getting colder. Right now it's 19 in Burlington. Pitch to Valentin. Struck him out. Abbott got him to change. So 1-2 fastball. So two out for Carlos Lee at 308. 7 homers and 26 RBI. It would be fair to say the White Sox and the Reds are the two positive surprises on the season. The Braves, who you'll see tomorrow versus the Giants at noon Eastern, are a negative surprise. It's Mark Gardner versus Greg Maddux tomorrow at 9, or noon Eastern. Pitch to Lee, Carlos in the left center, back goes Cameron, and Mike will make the catch, and that will retire the side. White Sox get a hit and gets thrown out trying to steal second. Half an inning in the books, no score. Day baseball is back. 36 in Vegas. You had a little snow. Rocky Biddle. That sounds like an ice cream flavor, doesn't it? Making a 7th start of the year. He's 0-2 with a 5.73 ERA. I'm sure the women in his hometown said, I want me a scoop of Rocky Biddle. Rocky's 25, fastball at 91 and a fly ball pitcher. 71 wherever John is today. Last pitched on the 10th against Anaheim, a 5-4 win for the Shy Sox. 6 1/3, 102 pitches, 6 hits, 3 runs all earned. A homer, he walked nobody and struck out 4. So 33 innings for Rocky, 39 hits, 24 runs, 21 earned. 11 walks, or 5 homers, 11 walks, and 18 strikeouts. Going down to 30s this weekend. Oh, supposed to get down to 3 below here tomorrow night. I don't feel sorry for you. Ichiro leads off. He's hitting on a 10-game hitting streak in right field. McLemore at third will bat second. Edgar Martinez, the DH, goes third. John Olerud cleans up at first. Brett Boone at second will bat fifth. Cameron batting sixth in center field. Javier in left seventh. Lampkin behind the plate eighth. And Guillen at short will bat ninth. Abbott through 8 pitches in his half of the first. Defensively for Chicago, Carlos Lee is 6-6 in left. Singleton is 7-6 in center. Maggie Adornia is a 4-9 in right. Herbert Perry a 4 at third. Valentin a 4 at short. Durham a 7 at second. Leifer a 2 at first. Alomar Jr. towards the end of his career, a 3-2 behind the plate. And Biddle is an 8 with a 9.55 fielding percentage. Ichiro at 343, 4 homers, and 19 RBI. And Biddle starts his night with a pop-up third base side. Perry on the grass, 1 out. For Mark McLemore, Mark at 221, no homers and 10 RBI. So, yep, a little more snow coming here. We got about what we expected in the first batch. And then they were calling for 10. We're probably, when all is said and done, going to get about 8. Slow ground ball to Durham. 2 out. So here is Edgar Martinez. Edgar at 329. 13 homers and 41 RBI. How you doing, Steeler fan? So any suggestions for our show topic? Dave and I are supposed to tape today. And Edgar draws the walk. And that will bring up Olerud. 319, 4 homers, and 21 RBI for John. So runner on first, two outs. Scoreless game in the first. White Sox and Mariners in what could be an ALDS preview. Fly ball, right field. Ordonez will make the catch, and that will retire the side. No runs, no hits, no errors. A lead runner on after one, no score. So here's Maglio Ordonez. Boy, he's off to a flying start. 352, 4 homers and 19 RBI. This is game 37 for the Shy Sox and 39 for the Mariners. Abbott starts the second. In the left center, Cameron moving over. Makes the catch, one out. Brings up Konerko. Paul at 291, 4 homers and 29 RBI. One out, top of the second. Paul swings into deep left center field. Back goes Javier. And it was Javier is the one who stretched. Two out. Maybe learning to let go when you don't like a game. I'll bounce that one off him. He was talking about perfect. What's the perfect game? But he did that last night after my game. So that's a good topic. Jeff Leifer, 1-for-9 on the replay. 256 overall, 18 homers and 39 RBI. Two out, Abbott deals. Ground ball, Boone will cut it off on the grass in front of second over to Olerud, and that will retire to side. No runs, no hits, no errors. After an inning and a half, no score. So Biddle taking his warm-up tosses. It'll be Boone, Cameron, and Javier here in the second. Brett at 338, 9 homers, and 33 RBI. In the right field, Ordonez tries to size that one up. He will. And no, that's off the wall. I thought he made the catch. He got the glove up a bit late, and Boone is on second with a 6 double of the year. He hit it well, didn't he? So here's Mike Cameron, 214, no homers, and 4 RBI. Ground ball to Biddle, over to Leifer. And that's two out, or one out. Boone stays in second. So here's Javier, staying at 283, a homer, and 5 RBI. Walked him. It'll be the Giants and the Braves tomorrow at lunch. Maddox and Gardner. Here's Tom Lampkin. He threw out Ray Durham at second, trying to steal. In the first, 237 overall, a homer and 6 RBI. Tom pops it up right side. Durham runs over, makes the catch. In foul territory, two out for Guillen. Carlos at 267, 2 triples and 12 RBI. First and second for Seattle, and two out. Got him. Biddle got him to look in strike three. And so the Mariners leave two on. They cannot score. No runs, one hit, no errors. We go to the third here in Seattle. It's the White Sox nothing, the Mariners nothing. So here's Herbert Perry. Again, these White Sox pictures look like they're trying to sell an album or something, don't they? You smear a little Vaseline on that lens, and Herbert could be crooning his greatest hits. Herbert at 275, a homer and 10 RBI. The White Sox would like him to get a hit. In the left, Javier. And that ball is gone. Oh, yeah, he got a hit all right. Stretch. So Perry won the second of the year. Just crushed that. That got way too much of the plate. So 1-0 Chicago. Brings up Chris Singleton. 253, 3 homers, 11 RBI. Popped up. Boone by the bag at second. Makes the catch. One out for Alomar. Sandy must go back to Cleveland at some point this year. 232, 4 homers. So he's reached his real life total and has driven in 14. One out. Abbott. Wines and deals. Liner in the left. That's going to get around for extra bases. Javier is going to go fish it out. Alomar's got two easy, and that's where the throw is going. So Sandy has his second double of the year. So the White Sox now have three hits. And as Ray Durham steps to the plate with a single, 1-for-1, opening 9 for Abbott, 37 pitches, 2 1/3, 3 hits. The home run to Perry and a strikeout. Paul Deals gets away from Lampkin and Alomar Jr. goes to third. So he moves up 90 on the wild pitch. And the count is 2-0 to Durham, who was thrown out trying to steal in the first. In the right center, Cameron moving over. Will make the catch. Alomar goes back to tag. Both are average, and the throw goes in the infield. Alomar scores. 2-0 Chicago. So that brings up Valentin, who struck out his first time up. And now you're starting to get an understanding of why the White Sox are so good. This is a pretty solid offense. Base hit up the middle. Cameron will pick it up, and that's the fourth hit for Chicago. A 1-2 change just rifled in the center field. So here's Lee. How you doing, pesky Paul? Mike grading papers. Had a good one last night between the Red Sox and the A's. Carlos Lee is 0-for-1. Abbott's pitch. Fly ball, left field, Javier. This will stay in the yard, and Stan will make the catch to retire the side. Big inning for Chicago, however. 2 runs, including the solo homer by Perry. 3 hits and no errors. We go to the bottom of the third here at Safeco. 2-0. All right. Well, I won't spoil it for you, but it's not going up till after 9:30. So top of the lineup for Seattle, it'll be Ichiro, McLemore, and Edgar. Biddle, 45 pitches for his first 9. That's a lot. 2 innings, a hit, 2 walks, and a strikeout. You wouldn't think he'd work that hard, considering there's only a 0-1 on the board for the Mariners. So Ichiro on a 10-game hitting streak isn't going to bunt. 0-for-1, now 1-for-2. That goes to 11 as he punches that one into right center for a single. Only the second hit for Seattle. So here's McLemore. Mark is 0-for-1. Biddle throws to first. Suzuki is picked off. So both teams have had a runner picked off of first. Technically, Durham was a caught stealing. They got Ichiro napping. And there's one on and nobody out. Oh, wow. A long one to read. McLemore is 0-for-1, by the way. John says, to piggyback on that, not just a one to let go, but how quickly does one realize they've had enough? 2 streams? You've seen some of my projects. Or are you patient? For John, a game has to hook him the right way. For instance, RSBB. Regular season basketball didn't hook me because I realized that as I was computing all the stats, I could have just played a full game like Strat. Haven't picked up regular season basketball since the first day you printed it out. That's one for me to talk about that game. Pitch to McLemore. That's in the left center. Singleton goes back and Chris will make the catch. 2 out. That's a put a puzzle together game. And sometimes you're in the mood for it to see how it breaks out. But as far as if I want to coach something, I like Strat. I told you last night I'm working on a way to try to make Above the Rim streamable. Because that is, A, I think it's the best free game out there. And B, it's a full play game where it just plays out in front of you. We've done that talk before, whether you like to make decisions in a game or whether you just want to play out. Edgar Martinez just wants to bat. He walked his first time up. And he draws another walk. So two out. Olerud is 0 for 1. Do you wonder if the Veterans Committee would give Olerud any love? He was just such a solid player for so long. I don't think his numbers, actually I don't know his numbers off the top of my head, aren't going to get him into Cooperstown, but the teams he played on were certainly better because he was there. Pitch to Olerud. Here's a ground ball to Durham. Goes to Valentin for the easy out. And that will retire the side. No runs. A hit. They leave a runner on. We go to the fourth. 2-0 Chicago. So Ordonez, Konerko, and Liefer, Liefer, to face Abbott here in the fourth. Maglio is 0 for 1. DeGuian. And Carlos bobbles it, picks it up, long throw to first, and Ordonez, not known for his speed, is thrown out. You downloaded it, but how to install the teams and just trying to play it lost you. Okay, it's not that difficult. Open up the spreadsheet you want to play, or teams that you want to play. You cut and paste one team into visitor, then the other into home, go into the game screen, and hit lineups. And then select them from there. Scoop 85 is a master with that game if you're not a sub to him. And he probably does a better job of explaining that, and I don't want to steal anyone else's thunder. Konerko is 0 for 1, by the way. Abbott's pitch. Fly ball, left field, Javier racing back to the corner. That ball is gone. In the first row of the upper deck. And it's 3-0 Chicago. Pesky Pole says, Oluru, just lit him up in your 91 replay. Four-game sweep in Fenway. Sox have lost 7 in a row. Boo. You're welcome, John. How you doing, Tribe fan? Yeah, Olerud just, wherever he played, was fantastic. And Indian fans want Seattle to win. I knew what you were booing for. That was a shot and a half. So 3-0 Shy Sox. Here's Liefer, who's 0 for 1. Zalapsky Smurf, how are you? Got him. That's the second for Abbott. An 0-2 fastball swung on and missed. Two out. For Herbert Perry, we joked about him making a hit single, and he hit a home run in the third. A solo shot, his second of the year. Two out, top the fourth. Perry swings. That's a hard fly ball to left. Back goes Javier, and that ball is gone. So Herbert Perry, speaking of Indians, has smashed two. This one just hit the facade of the second deck. Sox bullpen on fumes, Jeff Gray being unavailable. They were on the downslope in 91. So now 4-0 Chicago. Golf clap for Perry. So two out, two runs on the board. Perry and Konerko with home runs. Only because he was on the 95 Indians and I think on one of my rotisserie baseball teams. And I got the worst end of that. Here's Singleton. He's 0 for 1. Into right center. Cameron moving over. And that'll do it. But two solo homers, two runs, two hits, no errors. And the White Sox have doubled their leads after 3.5, 4-0 Chicago. So here are the standings as we play the games of whatever day I said it was. I know it's a Saturday. The Marlins have lost 6 straight. They lead the Phillies by 2, the Mets by 2.5. Alomar scored a run, I think, already. Atlanta has won 7-10, so they're catching up. And again, we'll see them tomorrow. Well, these are the games of Wednesday. Reds have won 3 straight. They're hanging in there. 1.5 over Houston, St. Louis, and Milwaukee. In the West, Colorado and San Francisco are tied for first. Arizona 3 back, San Diego 4. American League, the Yankees have won 8 straight. They lead the Red Sox by 2.5. And in the Central, Cleveland has won 9 of 10, 3 straight. And a 2-game lead on Chicago. In the West, 8-10 for the Mariners and 4 straight. And they're the only team above 500. So Boone, Cameron, and Javier to face Rocky Biddle. Yep, damn Yankees indeed. Boone doubled his first time up. He sends this one high and deep to left. Back goes Lee to the track, to the wall, and that ball is gone. So Seattle is on the board with the Boone homer, his 10th of the year. And it's now 4-1 Chicago. Balls are flying out of here. We're technically playing in Seattle, the ballpark that features the football team that must not be named is in the background there. We haven't had a lot of slugfests. Here's Cameron. He's 0-1. Got him. 2-2 curveball on the black outside. Strike 3. For Javier, who walked his first time up. Chopper, Valentin in front of the bag. Snap throw to first. And he's out. So 2 away for Lampkin, who's 0-1. There's a liner in the right center field. Lampkin goes for 2, and he's in there. So he has a double. 2 out for Carlos Guillen, who struck out his first time up. 4th hit for Seattle. With 2 out here in the 4th. And there's a little looper that's going to get down in the right center field. Singleton will pick it up. Lampkin rounds 3rd. Singleton has a decent arm. He throws it in the infield, and the 2 runs Chicago got in the top of the inning have been erased. It's 4-2. And so Biddle, his opening 18, 3 2/3, 79 pitches. 5 hits, a home run. All 2 runs have been earned. He's walked 3 and struck out 2. Ichiro now has an 11-game hitting streak, as he is now 1-2. Guillen is good speed. We're going to hit and run. Pitch to Ichiro. Popped up. Alomar to the screen. Carlos watches. And that one is foul. So the count now 2 balls and a strike. And there goes Guillen. He did not get a good jump. So the count now is 2-2. With 2 out. Again, Rocky Biddle just sounds like an ice cream flavor, doesn't it? Pitch to Ichiro. He draws the walk. And now there is speed aplenty on for the Mariners. And that'll do it for Rocky. John Garland is coming in. We got a pitching change with 2 out in the 4th. This game is coming to you from Safeco Field in Seattle. Garland, his first relief appearance, he'll start 16 games. Is 2-0 with an earned run average of 172. He's just 21 years old, And that hitherto stare kind of tells you that. Fastball at 90 and a ground ball pitcher. John last started on the 12th, so he's on 3 days rest. Sorry, we don't do spam. I might sound like spam, but we don't do it. And that 6-2 win over the Rangers, 5 innings, 85 pitches. A hit, he walked 3 while striking out 4. Overall, 15 2/3. Again, and all these were starts. 9 hits, 3 runs all earned. Walking 9 and striking out 8. So McLemore with 2 out is 0-for-2. Guillen on second, Ichiro on first. 4-2 Chicago, 2 out, bottom of the 4th. Runners go, ground ball right side. That's in the hole. Is Guillen going to round third? He is. Ordonez picks it up. Guillen will score without a throw, and it's now 4-3 Chicago. John Midlife Crisis had a ball thrown by Garland, also named John, from when they were in Philly several years back. Very suspect and not just a scuff from the bat. Ooh.
Ooh.
Inquiring minds want to know. So first and second now, 2 out. Ichiro the tying run. A big inning for Seattle. And here's Edgar Martinez, who has walked twice. Garland deals, struck him out. And so the White Sox still hold on to the lead, but they're in the pen now. 3 runs, 4 hits, and no errors. We go to the 5th here in Seattle, 4-3 Chicago. Distinct tack marks. So here's Sandy Alomar Jr. Doubled and scored his first time up. Abbott starts the 5th. Fly ball, center field. Cameron moving over in the left center. 1 out. You kind of do that to make us some meat tenderized. And a pitch to break. Here's Ray Durham. He's 1-for-1. A sack fly drove in the run. Abbott opening 18, 74 pitches, 4 1/3, 6 hits, 3 home runs, 1 from Konerko, and 2 from Herbert Perry. And he has struck out 2. In the right, Ichiro in the corner has it. 2 out. For Valentin, Jose has singled and struck out. Abbott winds and deals. Slow bounder to Olerud, who takes it to the bag, and that will retire the side. Clean top of the 5th for the Mariners and Paul Abbott. We go to the bottom of the 5th, halfway home on a cold day in Burlington. It's the White Sox 4, the Mariners 3. So if you joined us late, here's how we got here. Or actually, I was told to change that up a bit. Thanks for that. Mike, 80 degrees in South Carolina. You go enjoy your yard work. Father who buys Crocs for their kids to play basketball in. Anyway, if you joined us late, what the hell took you so long? Anyway, here's how he got here. Herbert Perry, a solo shot in the 3rd to make a 1-0 Chicago. Ray Durham, a sack fly to make it 2-0 in the third. Ichiro now has an 11-game hitting streak. In the fourth, Chicago doubled their pleasure, doubled their fun with a Paul Konerko homer, his fifth of the year, to make it 3-0. Herbert Perry, a solo shot to make it 4-0, his third of the year. I have a feeling that you'd had enough of the Lake Ontario weather. Is that how you ended up in South Carolina? In the fourth, Seattle took 3 runs off that lead. Brent Boone with a solo homer to make it 4-1. Carlos Guillen a single to score. Tom Lampkin and Mark McLemore single to score Guillen to make it 4-3. Rocky Biddle. Well, Rocky is an appropriate name for that start. 3 2/3, 5 hits. 3 runs all earned. Garland now gets to clean it up for Chicago and hold on to the lead. Biddle, by the way, not eligible for the win. Paul Abbott, 5 innings, 6 hits, 4 runs all earned, 3 long balls, and 2 strikes. Outs. John Olerud is 0-2. As we start the fifth, ground ball to Durham. Ray throws it over for the out, one away. For Brett Boone, came to college and was smart enough to stay. Nothing wrong with that. Here's Brett Boone. Brett has doubled and homered. He's 2-2. His homer is the 10th of the replay. 34 RBIs now. Ground ball to Durham. Second verse, same as the first. 2 out for Cameron. Mike is 0-2 with a strikeout. So it looks like Garland made the right call. They made the right call in putting Garland in the game. Draws the walk. Nothing like an announcer's jinx. No, here's Javier. Stan is 0-1. He walked. Garland throws to first. Cameron is back and not really in a position now where you'd want to steal him. Pitch to Javier. Ball 4. So another walk and the Mariners have first and second. 2 out for Lampkin, who was 1-2. With a double and a run scored. By the way, Javier looked at a full count fastball for ball 4. Excuse me. Pinch to Lampkin. Fly ball to right, but Ordonez should track that one down. He does, and that will retire the side. No runs, no hits, no errors. They leave on 2. Seattle is left on 8. Believe it or not. We go to the 6th, 4-3 Chicago. So Lee, Ordonez, and Konerko. Carlos is 0-2. To Guillen, it's short in the hole, has a long throw to first, 1 out. Have any of you ever had a 4 home run game? Here's Ordonez. Maglio is 0-2. Abbott winds and deals. Line drive to Olerud. 2 out. So here's Konerko. Paul hit his 5th of the year his last time up. He's now driven in 30. Remember, this is game 37 for the White Sox. Line drive, foul, third base side. A goat from Bellingham made that catch, and the count was full. 3-2. Abbott now over 100 pitches. With 2 out here in the 6th. Right back up the box. Throws it to Olerud. And that will retire the side. Kelly Wunsch. Wunsch. Sounds like something you do in the Iditarod. Coming in to pitch. Kelly, a lefty, making his 19th appearance of the year. Is that one of those ones that you really should pronounce like Wench or something like that? He's 28, features a slider at 87 and a ground ball pitcher. He does not have a 1-loss record. He does have a save and a 5.68 ERA. Last pitched on the 12th in that 6-2 win over the Rangers. 1 inning, 19 pitches, and that's it. Overall, 19 innings, 17 hits, 12 runs all earned. He's given up 4 homers, walked 10, and struck out 10. Mike had a Ted Williams 3-homer day in his 41 PC replay against the Senators. Did you finish that? Did he finally finish above 400? And John had one from Mike Schmidt in 83, the 83 Schmidt cards and dice, and Strat almost 40 years ago. So Kelly's good for about an inning. Guillen, 1-for-2, sac fly, RBI, strikeout, and a run scored. Kelly starts his effort, a ground ball to Valentin over to Leifer, one out. I don't think I've had a 4 home run game ever. I had a cycle on one of these streams, didn't realize it till it was over. Till the game told me. Here's Ichiro, he's 1-for-2, he is singled and walked. Little ground ball down to second, Durham on the grass throws it to first, and they get the speed of Ichiro, 2 out for McLemore. Bark 1-for-3 with an RBI, and that hit was a single. To Durham again, Ray has to hurry, Leifer on the bag, and that will retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Mariners in the sixth. After 6, Chicago 4, Seattle 3. Wow. So in your replay, he hit 415. He hit 406 in real life and actually came into the day hitting, what, 403? Doubleheader for the Red Sox to close out the 41 season. Not that I personally remember. Homer twice in the final day to tie York for the lead league in homers and win the Triple Crown. I gotta ask, I know you played the Red Sox. Did DiMaggio have anything close to a long hitting streak? Leifer, by the way, 0-for-2 in the strikeout. Ball 4. So first walk for Abbott. So here's Herbert Perry. He has 2 solo homers on the day. If you like Deuces Wild, Herbert Perry's your guy. 4-3, White Sox, nobody out, top the 7th. Perry swings, it should be 2. Guillen to Boone for 1. Brett pivots, throws to 1st. And I still won't have a 4 home run game. So 6-4-3 on the DP, 2 out for Singleton, who is 0-for-2. He drops a bunt down. And that one is foul, and the count now is 0-2. Got him! Struck him out. Bob Howry coming on to pitch. Stretch time here in Seattle, 4-3 Chicago. Let's tell you about Bob Howry here as we start at the bottom of the 7th. He's a righty, 27 years old, ground ball pitcher, and the fastball tops out at 93. 19th appearance for Bob. He's 1-0 with a 3.20 ERA. Last pitch on the 12th against the Rangers. Went one inning, 20 pitches, a hit, and 2 strikeouts. They used the kitchen sink, it looks like, in that 6-2 win. Overall, Bob, 19 2/3, 20 hits, 7 runs all earned, 3 homers allowed. He's walked 4 and struck out 16. Pesky Pole, by the way, has a YouTube channel, if you're not aware of that. He did the simulcast and was jumping into the Tigers game to watch all of Rudy York's at-bats. York's final at-bat was a deep fly ball to left. but no cigar. And certainly not a Dutch Masters for sure. Here's Edgar Martinez. He's 0-for-1. He has walked twice and struck out once. The bat has not left the shoulders. And it still won't. As he looks at a 1-2 fastball on the outside corner. So one out for Olerud, who's 0-for-3. Four runs, six hits, no errors for Chicago. They've left on one. That's efficient. Three runs, six hits, no errors for Seattle. And they have left on eight. That is not efficient. Pitch to Olerud. Struck him out. A 2-2 fastball swung on and missed. So Howery coming out like a house of fire has two outs for Boone. Brett 2-for-3. He has doubled and homered. A solo shot for his 10th of the year. Now has driven in 34. Howery's pitch struck him out. Good morning, good afternoon, and good night. After 7, 4-3, Shy Sox. It's not a word you want to say real fast, Shy Sox. Just saying. So Alomar, Durham, and Valentin here in the 8th. Abbott has given the Mariners yeoman's work through 7. And probably is down to a base runner. Sandy is 1-for-2. He has doubled and scored. Ball 4, and I'll keep my word on that, I think. How many pitches? We'll go one more. We'll go Durham. 27 batters deep for Abbott. 117 pitches. 6 hits. 3 homers. 1 to Konerko and 2 to Herbert Perry. He has walked 2 and struck out 3. Durham is 1-for-2. He has singled and driven home a run. Teddy Ballgame won the AL MVP. The writers aren't dumb in PC Replay Baseball. Pete Reiser won the NL MVP for the Dodgers. I'm assuming he's with the Dodgers in 41. And in almost a rematch in 1940, the Yankees beat the Reds in 5 in the World Series. The Yankees didn't win the pennant in 40. It was the Tigers. But the Reds won the National League. We'll give him Durham. Lampkin and Abbott have a word. Paul from the set. Ground ball to Olerud. John takes it to the bag himself. And Durham is retired. So one out for Jose, who's 1-for-3. He has singled and struck out. Got him! That's 4. A 1-2 fastball. Cut on and missed. For strike 3, that's his 4th. The Dodgers choked down the stretch, I'm being told, in that 41 replay, because it was the Yankees. It was the first Yankee-Dodger World Series. It was 41, if I'm not mistaken. So 2 out for Lee, who is 0-for-3. Abbott walks him, and that'll do it for Paul. I tried to get him that last out. But with Maggie Ordonez coming to the plate, it's going to be Jeff Nelson. Coming in, we got a pitching change. This game coming to you from Safeco Field in Seattle. So Nelson, all right, enjoy. We're almost done. Thanks as always for all of you that come in and watch. Nelson 3-1 with a 2.76 ERA, making his 18th appearance. 34 years old, slider at 91. Yet Dodgers and Yankees was the one that Mickey Owen dropped the strike 3 as a catcher. So a slider at 91 and a ground ball pitcher for Nelson. He last pitched in a 10-9 win over the Jays on the 11th, inning in a third, 34 pitches, 3 hits, 3 runs, but only 1 earned. No homers. A walk and a strikeout. So Nelson on the season. Yeah, I was thinking that too. Todd B. jumps in at the very end here. I wish some guy named Costello could relieve Abbott. Wouldn't that been funny? How you doing, Todd? 16 and a third innings for Jeff. 11 hits for Nelson. 7 runs, 5 earned, a homer. He's walked 10 and struck out 18. So first and second, 2 on, 2 out here in the 8th, 4-3 Chicago. Ordonez is 0 for 3. Nelson, as soon as I put the mouse in the right spot. Ground ball to first. Olerud has it. Takes it to the bag. And that will retire the side. Josh Fogg coming in to pitch for the White Sox in the bottom of the eighth. We played 7.5, 4-3 White Sox. Josh's older brother, London, is a coat and a coffee drink. Josh is 24. Throws the cutter at 93 in a fly ball pitcher, making his ninth appearance of the year. No record and an earned run average of 982. You think Elvis Costello may have played the theme for the next pitcher. Best you can do. You can say anything you want, but his name is Veronica. Work doesn't allow it for Ty B. We are on Tuesday nights, by the way, at 8:30. Fogg last pitched on the 12th. Again, I think they used everybody on the 12th, which is hard to do in a 6-2 win. In fact, Josh gave up both of the Texas runs. Yep, Tuesday nights at 8:30, because the wifey has an appointment during the morning hours. So lunchtime the rest of the week. But Tuesday night in prime time, inning in the third for Josh that game. 28 pitches, 3 hits, 2 runs all earned. Striking out 3. 7 in the third innings for Josh. 11 hits, 8 runs all earned. He walked 2 and struck out 13. So as we start the bottom of the eighth, the Mariners need 1 to tie and 2 to go ahead. Cameron, 0 for 2, will walk in a strikeout. Fogg starts his effort. Line drive to left past Lee. That's extra bases. Cameron can fly. And the tying run is on second. Faster than you can say, Anbusol. The seventh hit for Seattle. Javier 0 for 1. He has walked twice. Stan delivers in the center field. He's in the second with a stand-up double. This ball game is tied at 4. So Fogg is pitching like he's in 1. He is in 1. So 2 hits back-to-back, 2 doubles, and it's 4-4 for Lampkin. Tom is 1 for 3. He has doubled and scored. Javier has good speed on second. And Lampkin gets hit. Crowd doesn't like it. Hit him in the ribs. So Perry is going to play for the bunt. That's interesting. And Leifer is playing back. Nobody out. 4-4 tie. Nope, I'm looking at the batting average and it says 326. So we're swinging away. So Fogg trying to get his head together. That might be 2. Valentin on the bag at second. The throw to Leifer is close. And Guillen beats it out. So a 4-U on the fielder's choice. Javier on third to go ahead run. Guillen on first for Ichiro. Talk about going right from the frying pan into the fire. Ichiro now has an 11-game hitting streak, 1 for 3 with a walk. Alomar and Fogg have a word. In the center field, that's deep enough to score Javier for sure. Singleton makes the catch. Javier tags. He's going home, and the Mariners lead it 5-4. So another exciting ballgame here on Retro Sports Network. Brings up Mark McLemore, who was 1 for 4 with an RBI. Fogg goes to the plate, strikes out McLemore too little too late. The Mariners pull ahead, 2 runs, 2 hits, and no errors. We go to the ninth. It is 5-4 Seattle. So, Kazuro Sasaki comes in for the save. He has done that 14 times this replay. 1-1. He's 33 years old with an earned run average of 255. He's a splitter pitcher. Fastball tops out at 89. Excuse me, a fly ball extreme pitcher. He's converted 14 of 16 saves. He last pitched on the 12th, a 6-5 win over Toronto. He got the last out, picked up the save on 13 pitches, two hits, so it was dicey. The 2000 Rookie of the Year struck out a batter, 17 and two-thirds innings, 13 hits, 5 runs all earned, 4 homers. Red Sox tattooed him for 2 on the 10th. He has walked 2 while striking out 22. And it wouldn't be Todd B. without mentioning his best friend George Hendrick. They exchange Christmas cards, you know, except for George is too lazy to put the postage stamp on it. Hendrick retired by 88. Todd thinks he retired when he was with the Indians. So Konerko, Leifer, and Parry in a one-run game in the ninth. So the White Sox need 1 to tie and 2 to go ahead. Konerko has a homer. That came in the third. That was 5 on the replay. 1-for-3. Fly ball left field. 1 out for Leifer, who is 0-for-2. He has walked and struck out. Suzuki winds and deals. Ground ball to Boone. Over to Olerud. 2 out. Konerko used to kill everybody, Todd. It wasn't just Cleveland. And so Herbert Parry, who looks deep into your eyes, is the last chance to loon for the White Sox. He has homered twice today. He now has 3 on the replay with 12 RBI, now hitting 287. Steeler fan watching and enjoyed my video. The new computer making doing something like that easier? Not specifically for that. It's just, you know, one of the things I think we all get into is we all get different project ideas. I wanted to see how easy it would be for me to play manually. And I did that Dodger Red Sox game, and it took about 20 minutes for Pedro just to dominate. Anyway, Parry says, enough about you. What about me? Suzuki trying to nail this one down, and Royce Clayton's going to pinch hit. Wow. What do you mean a 162 batting average isn't going to get it done? That 168, of course, makes it all the better. As a pinch hitter, Clayton is 2-for-3 for a 667 overall, 278, a homer and 14 RBI. Yeah. So again, Royce Clayton, the last chance saloon for the White Sox. Suzuki is ready. Into right field, Ichiro will get a glove on it, and the Mariners win it 5-4. So a beautiful game here in Seattle. 3 hours and 19 simulated minutes, 5 runs, 8 hits, no errors. The Mariners get away with leaving on 9 and winning. They are now 27-12. The White Sox, 4 runs, 6 hits, no errors, and they leave on 3. Josh Fogg, the wrong choice from the computer's point of view in the 8th. 2 hits, 1 inning, and 2 runs. Garland, whoosh? How the heck would you pronounce that? And Howry, a good job for Chicago out of the pen, but all for naught. Paul Abbott, 7 2/3, 6 hits, 4 runs, all earned. 3 homers, including the 2 to Parry. He walked 3 and struck out 4. You're welcome, Tribe fan. Mariners play. So, oh, Todd. M's playing out the strings so they can choke in the playoffs. Oh. You're welcome, Bernie. Nelson gets the win. He goes to 4-1. And Sasaki nails down save number 15. Ouch. The rest of this Saturday, or Wednesday, rather, in baseball. May 16th, Atlanta beats Colorado 6-5. Relinger 2-5. Gabe White 1-2. Perez homered his 4th of the year and drives in 4. It was not fun to watch. Well, I'm sorry you feel that way. Pittsburgh beat St. Louis 2-1. Schmidt goes to 2-0. Daryl Kyle, 3-4. Drew, 2-3, is 11th of the year. Cincinnati beats Arizona. Wow, 7-2. Oh, okay, yep. I don't think they'll fall apart as much in the playoffs. But thanks for joining us, Clyde, man. Don't be a stranger in these things. Winchester. And thanks for the follow. Charles Emerson Winchester gets the... Kurt Schilling takes the loss. 5-1. Tucker, 3-4, is third of the year. Philadelphia, 10-4 over Milwaukee. Bruce Chen, 2-3. Kunane is 1-2. Marlon Anderson, 3-4 with a double. Padres beat the Mets 7-2. Adam Eaton, 2-4, where your value is always guaranteed. Glendon Rush goes to 1-4. Bubba Trammell, 3-4. Dodgers beat the Expos 6-5. Carrera, 1-0. Peters, 0-5. Sean Green, a homecoming for country coming for him, 4-4, is 11th of the year and stole a base. San Francisco beats Florida 6-2. Kirk Reeder, 5-2. Clement, 2-2. Barry Bonds, 3-4, is 15th. Detroit beats Baltimore 6-4. Weaver, 3-5. Kohlmeier, 0-2. Cruz, is that Devi? Is 3-5 with two doubles. Houston beats Chicago 6-1 at Wrigley. Reynolds, 4-0. Julian Tavares is 0-4. Craig Biggio, 1-4. His fifth of the year and drives in two. Tribe doubles Texas 4-2. Bartolo Colon is 4-1. Moreno is 0-1. Yep, the Astros win. Cordova, 2-4. Marty hit his fifth and drives in two. Red Sox double the Mariners. The Twins 6-3. Arroyo 4-1. Romero 2-1. Lewis, Darren Lewis, 4-5, 3 RBI and 2 stolen bases. Mike Sweeney, 4-5, is ninth of the year, drives in three. The Chiefs beat the Bucks 9-6. Santiago goes to 3-1. Esteban Yan and Yu falls to 0-2. Yankees beat the A's 4-1. Andy Pettitte goes to 3-2. Barry Zito, 3-2. David Justice, 1-2. His fourth of the year and two walks. And last but not least, Anaheim, 9. Toronto, 8. Someone got the win. Lukaswich? Close enough. Painter takes a loss, 0-1. Garrett Anderson, 4-4. Seventh home run and drives in 2. Our luncheon meeting tomorrow will serve food and the Braves and the Giants, noon Eastern, 9 Pacific. Thank you so much for watching. Talk to you tomorrow. Have a good day, everybody. So long.